My dear Christian, I will talk in a very, very, very important topic. Watching this video and achieving what I will say now is very, very important. Watching this video and achieving what I will say now is a matter of life or death. But you can't understand the video unless you hear, and the last part in the video is the most important part. But you can't understand the last part in the video unless you hear all the video from the beginning to the end. I will say another time. Watching this video and achieving what I will say now is a matter of life or death. And the last two minutes in the video is the most important part, but you can't understand the last part in the video unless you hear all the video from the beginning to the end. And I'm sure if you hear me with your heart, my talking will penetrate your heart, because most of Christians are not arrogant and are not proud. I will talk about very great and incredible scientific miracles in the Holy Quran and Sunnah. And also I will make very important spots about very important points in your books. Hear me for your benefits. The God said in the Holy Quran, from more than 1,400 years, in chapter number 27, in Surah Eltharyat, in verse number 47, and we constructed the heaven with strength, and indeed, and we will keep expanding. And we constructed, the God said that, and we constructed the heaven with strength, and indeed, and we will keep expanding. Which means that the God said, from more than 1,400 years, that he will expand the heaven. The recent science proved that the heaven expands with a very high velocity, which it reaches 30,000 light years every 1 second, because there are 275 million stars are created or born it every day. For that, the heaven has to be expanded to accommodate these huge numbers of stars. And if the heaven doesn't expand, the universe will be burst. How the Prophet Muhammad, from more than 1,400 years, knew that the heaven expands, unless the God inspired that to him, unless he is a prophet from God. Very great miracle, which the Holy Quran said from more than 1,400 years that the heaven expands. The recent science proved that the heaven expands with a velocity which it reaches 30,000 light years every 1 second, because there are 275 million stars are created or born every day. Very great miracle, which pushes hundreds of Christians to convert to Islam. How the Prophet Muhammad knew that unless he is a prophet from God? In the opposite side, you said in your books that the God created the seven heavens and seven grounds in 6 days, and then he got very tired. For that, he gave himself a break or rest in Saturday. Is that logical? Is that reasonable to insult the God who have unlimited power and said about him that he got very tired, and after creating the heavens and the grounds? How dare you to believe that? How do you say that in your books? But this is your book. Another very great miracle in our book. The God said in Surah Al-An'am, in the Holy Quran, in chapter number 8, in verse number 125. In verse number 125. Whoever Allah wants to guide him to Islam, he make his breast expands to contain Islam. And whoever Allah wants to misguide him, he make his breast tighted and constricted as though he is climbing in the sky. This is an example for the people who don't want to believe. Which means that the God give an example for the people who don't want to convert to Islam. They are like the people who are climbing in the sky and they will feel suffocated. They can't breathe. The recent science proved that the percentage of oxygen decreases in the upper layers of the sky. As the Holy Quran said, from more than 1,500 years. How the Prophet Muhammad knew that? And he was an illiterate man. Can't read and can't write. How he knew that the percentage of oxygen decreases in the upper layers of sky? This very important fact was discovered only from a few years. As also the expansion of the sky is discovered from a few years. But the Holy Quran said that from more than 1,500 years. Very great miracle which pushes hundreds of Christians to convert to Islam. In the opposite side, you said in your books that the great prophet Dawood was looking from his window in his palace, in his house, in his home, and he saw a very beautiful woman. She was taking a shower. She was naked without clothes. He loved her. She was the woman, the wife of his leader, big leader Oria. He loved her. He made sex with her, and he betrayed his big leader Oria with his wife. And then he put Oria in a specific place in the army to make him killed, to put his hand on his wife. Is that logical? Is that reasonable to insult the great prophet Dawood and said about him that he makes the big sin adultery with a married woman? And who is she? She is the wife of his big leader Uriah. And then he killed him. How dare you to insult the prophets in your books? But this is your book, which you don't know who wrote these facts. Another very great miracle in our book. The Prophet Muhammad said in the Hadith, if the fly fall in the vessel, dip all of it and then remove it, that one of its wings is a disease and the other is a treatment. The recent science proved that one of the wings of the fly contains antibiotics. For that, the Prophet Muhammad from more than 1,400 years ordered us, if the fly fall in the vessel, to dip all of it. When you dip all of it, it will drop these antibiotics from the second wing, and it will, which will kill the microbes and the parasites which fall from the first wing, and it will pure and clean the vessel. How the Prophet Muhammad knew that? And now, there are more than a great study in USA and Australia proved that one of the wings of the fly contains antibiotics. And now they produce antibiotics from the treatment of many diseases from the body of the fly for the treatment of many diseases. How the Prophet Muhammad knew that? For more than 1,400 years, and he was an illiterate man. How he knew that one of the wings of the fly contains antibiotics? And he ordered us, if the fly falls in the vessel, to dip all of it. When you dip all of it, it will drop these antibiotics in the vessel, in the liquid, and it will kill the microbes and the parasites. Very great miracle, which pushes hundreds of Christians to convert to Islam. In the opposite side, you said in your books that the son of the great prophet Dawood was having a very beautiful sister. He loved her. She was very beautiful. He said to her, I want to make sex with you. She said to him, how much you will pay to me? He paid to his sister, and he made sex with his sister. The son of the Prophet Dawood made sex with his sister, and once the Prophet Dawood knew this illegal relationship between his son and his daughter, he got very angry, but he didn't punish his son because he was loving him. Who is the son of the Prophet Dawood? He is the Prophet Sulaiman. You insult the Prophet Sulaiman, the son of the Prophet Dawood, and said about him that he made sex with his sister. How dare you to say that in your books? How dare you to believe that? But this is your book. Another very, very great miracle in our book. The Prophet Muhammad said in the Hadith, every human being is created in his body about 360 joints, and he has to offer every day a charity or donation for every joint. His friend said to him, it is too hard to make that. He said to them, if you pray two rakas in the early morning, it will be equivalent for all that. The recent science proved that every one of us is created in his body about 360 joints, like Muhammad said, for more than 1,400 years. And this very important fact was discovered only from a few years. How the illiterate man who didn't read and he didn't write knew this very important fact for more than 1,400 years. Very great miracle which pushes hundreds of Christians to convert to Islam. In the opposite side, you said in your books that the great prophet Lot drink wine until he got drunk. Then he made sex with his daughters. And he made his daughters pregnant for him. Is that logical? The prophet Lot made sex with his daughters and make them pregnant for him. How dare you to say that? How dare you to believe that? You insult the God and you insult the prophets in your books. How dare you? This is your book, which you don't know who wrote these facts. Another very very great miracle in our book. The God said in Surah An-Najm, in chapter number 27. In the Holy Quran, in verse number 45 and 46. And he created the two mates, the male and the female, from a sperm drop when it is emitted. The God said that in the Holy Quran, in our book. And he created the two mates, the male and the female, from a sperm drop when it is emitted. Which means that the God said that he created the two types of fetus, whatever it is, male or female, from the sperm of the man. The recent science proved that the sperm of the man controls the type of fetus. And the recent science proved that the sperm of the man has two types, feminine sperm and male sperm. If the feminine sperm fertilizes the egg of the woman, the fetus will be female. And if the male sperm fertilizes, the fetus will be male. It was well known until a few years that the egg of the woman controls the type of fetus, until the recent science proved that the sperm of the man controls the type of fetus, and there is two types of sperms, like the Holy Quran said, from more than 1,200 years. How the Prophet Muhammad knew that? Very great, very, very, very great miracle, which pushes hundreds of Christians to convert to Islam. In the opposite side, you said in your books that the God settled down from the sky, and he walked in the ground, and he meet the great prophet Lut, the great prophet Yaqub. The great prophet Yaqub said to him, "Can you fight me?" The God said, "Yes, I can fight you." The prophet Yaqub fighted the God and defeated him, and then he put him in the ground, and then he hold him from his clothes, and said to him, "I will not leave you. Climb in the sky unless you called me Israel." He said, "Okay, you are Israel." Is that logical? A human being beat the God, and then he put him in the ground, and then he hold him from his clothes. How dare you to believe these facts? How dare you to believe this lying, this illusions? How dare you? But this is your book, which you don't know who wrote these facts. Another very great miracle in our book. The non-believers said to the Prophet Muhammad, "If you really a prophet from God, split this moon for us into two parts, and we believe you and support you." He said to them, "Can you give me a charter, a strong promise?" They said, "Yes, we give you a promise." He prayed to God, and the moon has split it into two parts. But the non-believer said to him, No, you charmed us with magic. This is magic." He said to them, "Why you broke your promises with me? I achieved what you want, and the moon has split it as you want, as you ask me." They said, "No, it is a magic." He said, "Okay, there are messengers. Will come after 2 days. We can ask them. If they saw which you saw, this means that it is not a magic. Is it okay? Because you know that the magic affects only the people in front of you, but it doesn't affect the people far away from you." And the messengers was about 100 kilometers. More than 100 kilometers. The messengers came after 2 days, and they said, "We saw a very strange thing. We saw that the moon has split it into two parts and was astonished. What is the matter?" But the non-believer said to him, No, your magic is very strong. It goes for a long way." For that, Sagat settled down in Surah Al-Qamar, in the Holy Quran, in chapter number 27, in verse number 1 and 2. "The last day has been soon, and the moon has split it. And if they saw a great miracle, they don't believe. And they said it is a strong magic." And this is always the character of the non-believers. They ask for a great miracle, although they know that this man is a prophet. And then they broke their promises because they are liars and they are arrogant. And I hope you are not like these people. When the instruments dropped on the surface of the moon, they found a very long and a huge crack dividing the moon. The length of this crack is 125 kilometers, and the width of this crack is 1,500 meters. And the depth of this crack is 500 kilometers. Very, very, very huge crack. The instruments was astonished. What is the matter? They never saw a crack like this in the ground. They made studies about this crack. They found that this crack impossible to come as a result of earthquake or volcano or any another thing. And one of the scholars of NASA agency in USA said that our studies proved that the moon has broken in the past and then it sealed another time, as the Holy Quran said, for more than 1,400 years, which proved without any doubt that the God has split the moon for his prophet from more than 1,400 years. Very great miracle, which wishes hundreds of Christians to convert to Islam. And I would, under this video, the image of the crack which is dividing the moon, and the video of the scholar who said that. In the opposite side, you said in your books that after the very hard fluid, which destroyed all the world in the period of the Prophet Nuh, the God got very sad, and the God cried. And then after he cried, he has pimples in his eyes. The God has pimples in his eyes. For that, the angels went to visit him. Is that logical? Is that reasonable to sit about the God who have unlimited power, that he is sick and he has pimples in his eyes? How dare you to say that? How dare you to believe that in your books? What is your book, which is full of facts? Another very great miracle in our book. A scholar called Masaru Emoto, Japanese scholar, make a very great book called Message from Water about the incredible effect of reciting the Holy Quran on the water. He found many strange things. He found after reciting the Quran in the water, the crystals started to move, and it made very beautiful structures, geometric structures, flowers. He took images for these structures and he put them in his book, Message from Water. And then he made studies about the water, the chemical structure of the water. He found that the penis of the water and the structure of the water is changed to be better and better, and the treatment of many diseases after reciting the Holy Quran on it. And I would the link of this book to read what he said. I will put under this video 8 or 9 great miracles provided with links to put what I have said, to prove what I have said. What do you want more than that after that to convert to Islam? All these miracles. If you don't want to believe until now that this Quran, the whole Quran, is from God, I'm sorry to say to you that you are arrogant. Because if I told you to look at the sun in the sky and you told me that you don't see anything, this means that you are arrogant or blinded. You have to know that all these miracles which I have said now is a drop from a big sea, from hundreds and hundreds of miracles in the Quran and Sunnah which wishes hundreds of Christians to convert to Islam every day. 5 Christians every 1 hour in USA converted to Islam, and 50,000 Christians in Egypt converted to Islam every 1 year because of these miracles. Now, I finish what I want to say. Drop under this video. You have to know that the Holy Quran said, the Holy Quran which contains all these miracles, said in Surah Ali Imran, in chapter number 3, in verse number 85, any person will accept any religion unless Islam will not be acceptable from him, and will be from the big losers in the last day. And the Prophet Muhammad says in the hadith, I swear with whom my soul is in his hand, any person hear about me, Jewish or Christian or any other religion, and don't believe me and don't believe the religion I came with, he will be one of the hell people. You will be one of the hell people if you don't convert to Islam. I made this video because I care about you. I afraid about you. Any person refused one of the prophets, this means that he refused all the prophets. If you refused Muhammad, this means that you refuse the Isa and Musa and all the prophets. This means that you are non-believer. You will fall in fire and you will never come out of it. Don't destroy yourself. Don't lose the paradise. You will cry in the last day, but you will not cry with tears. You will cry with blood. And you remember what I say now. And you will blame yourself because you don't obey me. And you will hope to return to the life for 1 second to convert to Islam, but the time will be off and the door will be closed. I finish what I want to say. Drop under this video and read all the miracles which I have written and press the links to make sure of what I have said. And after that, you don't have any excuse. And you will be the killer of yourself if you don't convert to Islam.